Hi everyone, this is Shivani here. Welcome to my channel Shivani Creations. Today I am showing you how to create this gorgeous and super beautiful table lantern or lamp with the handmade flowers, and it's looking absolutely stunning and it's really very easy to make. So without any further delay, let's start with the procedure. For today's project, I am using tropical cardstock value pack. This is a pack of 100 sheets and I am using this beige color for my today's project, but you will get 20 different shades in this value pack. So first I am taking this piece of cardstock which measures 10 by 12 centimeters, and from left side I am marking on 9 centimeters on top and 9 centimeters in the bottom. Just join the marking like this. Now rotate your sheet and again from left side mark on 11 centimeters on top and in the bottom. Make a line. So these two sides will be useful to stick our panels with each other. And now just find out the center between this, that is 4.5 centimeter. Make a line in the center. Then align 3 cm as a center on the line and mark at 1 cm and 6 cm. Then I'm joining this point with this and this point with this. So this is done. Now I'm going to make one frame inside this. So from top and from the bottom I'm marking on 1.5 centimeters. And making a line. And similarly from left and right side I'm marking on 1 centimeters. And making a line. So we have to cut this inner frame using paper cutter. Like this. Then parallel to this line, on right side I am marking on 1 cm. Just join this and now I am just cutting the excess paper using scissor. Now just making a crease line using ball tool, cutting this corner angle, and to burnish the folds I am using Dress My Craft bone folder. And this is done. In the same way we need total 4 panels for 4 sides. Now to decorate the panels, I have already cut these frames using Vintage Saga 6x6 paper pack by Dress My Craft, and also I'm using this acetate sheet which I'm going to add inside the frame, and this acetate sheet is from Dress My Craft again. This is a pack of 5 sheets. You can check the code here. And also I'm taking this beautiful background die cut out which is made using this floral background die by Dress My Craft. And to cut this I have used gold mirror cardstock. This is a beautiful cardstock. So now just take your base panel, add on your die cut, make a rough line, and leaving little gap from the marking, I am just cutting the shape and inside the panel I am going to stick this. To clear your die cutouts, you can use this brush tool by Dress My Craft, and also you will get the needle on back side to poke the excess pieces inside the intricate dies. And now I'm going to stick this inside the panel. Then I'm adding double-sided tacky tape on all four sides to adhere the acetate sheet. And then I'm covering this for the finishing using pattern paper frame. In the same way, I'm adding pattern paper frame in the front. So the panel is ready. With the same procedure, I have already decorated remaining three panels. So all four panels are ready. Now it's time to assemble our base of the lantern. So I'm just joining all four panels with each other. And our basic lantern is ready. Now I'm just covering the top using 9x9 cm cardstock. Like this. Then I'm taking this cardstock, which measures 8x8 cm, and from all four sides I have creased on 1 cm. Okay, so we just need to fold all the creases like this, and I have cut this small section here on all four sides to construct the box kind of shape. So just add glue and create a box. Like this. Then I'm taking one more cardstock piece, which measures 9x5 cm, and from top and bottom I'm marking on 1 cm. Make a line on the markings. Then mark in the center, that is on 4.5 cm. Take 3 as a center and mark on 1 end 6 cm. Now join this with this and this with this, and then I'm just cutting the excess paper and creasing the folded parts. Like this, I'm decorating it with pattern paper. I'm using the same pattern paper for my whole project, that is Vintage Saga. So we need total 4 panels. Now I'm just joining all 4 panels with each other. Like this. Then I'm taking 10 by 10 centimeter pattern paper and adding in the bottom. Also adding one pattern paper on the top, and then I'm adding my square box. Like this, decorating the inner part of square box using pattern paper piece, and it will be the base of our lantern, so you can just fix it like this very easily. Now I am going to show you the top. So for this I am taking this cardstock again, which measures 9 by 7 centimeters from top and bottom. I have marked on 1 centimeters and take the center. And this is 2.5 and this is 2.5 centimeters. So just join this with this and this with this. Just like we did before. Again, I'm cutting the excess paper and creasing the lines. Decorating it with pattern paper, so we need total 4 panels. Join all 4 panels with each other, and it's done. Adding one pattern paper on the top to decorate this. And sticking it with our lantern top. Like this. Now I'm just decorating the bottom using this beautiful daisy border. I have used white and gold mirror cardstock to create this, and this is a beautiful border by Dress My Craft. So I'm adding this border in the bottom. In the same way, I have added on 4 sides, and here I have added one strip of gold mirror cardstock on the top. So the lantern is ready. Now it's time to decorate it with flowers. So I'm starting with making the flowers, and here I have pre-cut my 5 petal flower using this flower die, and I have used the smallest size here. Now I am cutting each petal towards the center little bit so that we can shape the flower easily, shaping each petal from both the sides. Now I am using Vibrant Fuchsia and Cobalt Blue Archival Ink, and taking both the inks little bit on my sponge dauber and doing the shading from tip to the center part of the petal. like this. And from back side I'm coloring whole flower. Now for the center of the flower, I'm taking chrome yellow archival ink and just adding yellow color in the center like this. Now here I have cut some daisy flower using this die, and I have used third number die for this. All the dies which I'm using today are from Dress My Craft. For the leaf, I have used this die set and I have used the smallest size here. I have colored the daisy flower only for half portion using yellow color. And for all my flowers and leaves cutting, I have used soft floral oriental paper by Dress My Craft. Now I'm coloring the leaf using leaf green color and adding little cobalt blue on the top for a little deeper shade. Now I'm just adding little water using my spray bottle on the flower and leaf. Soak the excess water using tissue paper. And now I'm starting with the shaping. For this I'm taking small size groove golf tool and embossing pad by Dress My Craft. And from back side of the flower, I'm just shaping it like this. Similarly shaping the small flower and leaf. Now just rotate the flower and using the ball tool, pinch in the center to make a cup shape. Now I am adhering both the petals with each other. For this flower I have already done one more big petal and one small petal of flower. For the small petal, I have used this ruffled rose small flower and I have used the largest die here to create the small petal. Now I am adding all the layers together and creating the flower. Now to add the center of the flower, I am taking the funnel tray in the bottom and using golden flower pearls for the big flower. Just tapping the excess pearls, open the nozzle of your funnel tray and put all the flower pearls back inside the bottle. And for the small flower, I am using small size white color flower pearls. So I have created two large, two small, some filler flowers and some leaves, and also I have cut some foliages and leaves using different dies like this. And this is the tropical swirl die. For this I have used gold mirror cardstock, beige color cardstock and white cardstock which is colored using green archival ink. So the flowers and leaves are ready. Now it's time to decorate our lamp or lantern. Thank you. So after adding all the flowers, leaves, foliages, it's looking just awesome. Now I'm just adding my tea light in the center. So sticking the base first. And then you can just put the battery operated tea light inside this. You can also add fairy lights inside this lamp. And now I'm putting the top and fixing it. And tada, it's done. Wow. It's not looking like handmade, it's looking a ready-made, machine-made lamp. And you can easily make it with different color combinations. Isn't it looking pretty? So that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed my video. Please subscribe my channel for more interesting videos. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye-bye.